Hey, first graders. Today, I wanted to go over with you a little bit of information for your first lesson of art for the week of March 30th through April 3rd. On the sheet that was sent home, it shows you that we're going to be doing a color wheel review. And you're going to be creating your own color wheel as well. And you're going to have lots of options for how you want to do that. Make sure to remember to practice good craftsmanship with your coloring skills. So, also with your packet, you have worksheets that can help you with all of these projects. On the front of that packet is a color wheel. This is where you can first practice doing your coloring and remembering what the color wheel looks like. You're going to use any materials that you have or that you want to use. Be creative. You can use markers, you can use crayons, whatever you want. I'm going to use crayons for my example and show you a couple different options that you have. Make sure, again, when you're coloring in the right spots. On the practice one, they're all labeled for you. I want you to pay close attention to which colors are the primary colors, red, yellow, and blue, and which ones are the secondary colors, violet or purple, orange, and green. Now remember, the primary colors are what we use to make all of the other colors. So if I wanted to make purple, I could use my red and blue to make a purple. If I wanted to make green, I would use my yellow and blue to make my green. And if I wanted to make orange, I would use red and yellow to make my orange. You could also just use an orange crayon or orange marker, whatever you have, if you have the colors. Or if you want to practice mixing, that's great too. After you're done coloring in all of your color wheel nice and neat, you can take a picture of it through Seesaw and send it to your art teacher so that we can see what a great job you did with your coloring. When you're done with that, the next step is on the back side. It says color wheel. Now you can use this paper, or if you have a different piece of paper that you would rather use at home, that's fine too. I want you to be creative with how you create your color wheel on this side. You could make it look like different animals, like mice. A red mouse, an orange mouse, a yellow mouse, etc., to make a color wheel out of them. Or maybe it's a big flower and each petal is a different part of the color wheel. If you go onto the art website, there are lots of visual examples for you on there. Just like this one here, where they made the color wheel look like an umbrella with a person walking. So I can't wait to see what you come up with for this one. Feel free to use one of those ideas or come up with your own. Again, if you have any questions how to do this, please email your art teacher and we'll be more than happy to help you. Have a great day, and I can't wait to see what you create.